Before I attended the Job Alliance classes, I was a resident at the Haven of Grace, which is a shelter for homeless pregnant women.
I came from an alcoholic family. My stepdad and my mom are both alcoholics.
My friends weren't the best of friends. We got into, you know, a lot of altercations, running the streets, hanging out late, and, you know, just not living well morally.
I was adopted at the age of 11, and I grew up in Maine by an adopted family.
I didn't have a personal relationship with God. I knew that I wanted one for a better life for me and my daughter.
I went to school for 2 years, went to college, and then I dropped out. And I started doing a lot of drugs, and I backed myself into a corner pretty much.
A person knows when they're doing something that they're not supposed to be doing, you know? And then for the age I was 13, 14? And, you know, you shouldn't be staying out, you know, midnight, a little past midnight, and, you know, just doing things that your parents wouldn't approve of.
I just felt rejected. I just didn't feel loved by my parents. I ended up just having a down spiral toll of my life, and I turned to a lot of friends that really didn't give me good advice.
I knew when I became pregnant that I wanted to provide a better life for my daughter. I didn't know how I was going to accomplish that. I didn't have a support system. I didn't have any goals in place for me. And I didn't know exactly what I wanted to do.
I was very selfish as a young adult, and I wanted to do what I wanted to do when I wanted to do it. And I didn't want to listen to people. I didn't want to take any direction. And so I kind of just branched out into my own and did my own thing.
I was just, just going to school and just hanging out. I really didn't, I wasn't thinking about college and, you know, majors or anything like that, like building relationships with people. I was just, I don't know, living a blind life, I guess.
I felt empty. I felt like nobody wanted me. I just started experimenting with drugs and sex and that lifestyle. And I was a runaway. I ended up running away from home at the age of 17.
Growing up, I knew that I wanted to help individuals like myself who were, you know, in the same situation in a single parent home. I knew that I didn't want that type of life for my daughter. I wanted something better for her.
I ended up meeting a man when I was 20, and he became the father of my children. I was still desperate for help. Even though I had become a mom, I didn't know how to rear my children. I still didn't have a job. I was depending on the welfare system. I felt like I was just running from my past, but my past kept haunting me. And so one day I just came to the realization that I needed help.
I just started to get an idea of maybe I should change my lifestyle. And like in school, I was always, you know, I had good grades and I was pretty smart or whatever. And I just didn't want to mess it up because I knew I had the potential to be something greater.
I just pretty much got at the very bottom. And that's when I realized that I needed to do something, I needed a change, and I needed help. And it took me trying to do it myself for so long to realize that I needed other people to be able to live in this world.